Number 6, never release a goldfish into the wild. Your pet goldfish may look harmless when it's swimming around its glass bowl, but if it's released into the wild, these little guys become a real problem. They can be an invasive species, and the carp family member is known to start binge eating, and they become gigantic. It's not only that they prey on native species wherever they're introduced, but another concern factor is their dookie. For example, in Lake Tahoe on the California-Nevada border, the giant goldfish population started affecting the clarity of the lake because their boo-boo fueled algae growth. Moreover, the harmful chemicals in their excrement can adversely affect native species. In an aquarium, it's not uncommon for the goldfish to die due to a buildup of their own toxins. The goldfish eats like there's no tomorrow and produces killer poo. Think twice about letting one loose. Number 5. The Burmese python is one of those fun snakes that will hug you to death. As a constrictor, the python wraps its body around prey and then starts to squeeze until it takes the victim's breath away. Extreme specimens can grow to be over 23 feet long. Between 1996 and 2006, about 90,000 pythons were imported to the US to satisfy the country's demand for pet snakes. And some of those snakes were released by their owners and blossomed into a dangerously invasive species. Most notably in southern Florida. In the places where they've become well established, the pythons have reduced fox, rabbit, raccoon, possum, and certain deer populations. They even threatened the already endangered Florida panther. It got so bad that in 2013, the state organized a contest for a month in which it offered rewards for captured pythons. This is still an ongoing issue, particularly since the giant serpents don't have natural adversaries in Florida's wildlife. American alligators are really their only threat, and there's been a ton of reports of conflicts between the two species. Personally, I think that an alligator battling a Burmese python would make a perfect Florida flag. Number 4. Florida's home to more invasive species than any other state in the US. And one of these species is the rhesus macaques. During the late 1930s, a tour operator known as Captain Tui released 6 monkeys on an island in a river that runs through Silver Spring National Park. He did this to make his jungle cruise a little more entertaining. Tui thought that he could create a Tarzan-style park right in the middle of Florida. So he unleashes the primates, thinking they'd be a neat thing to add to the island. And of course, Tui did absolutely no research, because it turns out that macaques can totally swim. Like, no problem. They're the Michael Phelps of monkeys. So obviously they get right off the island, and they just go to town on the park. Fast forward several decades later, and the macaques are still thriving along the river area. Exotic pet enthusiasts are usually fascinated by the idea of owning a rhesus macaque. However, they soon realize that this monkey is really bad-tempered, so having one of your own is a terrible idea. The Floridian wildlife authorities typically regard these rhesus macaques as a public health risk. There are more than 1,000 of them living in Florida today, and most of those captured tested positive for the herpes B virus. Some dirty monkeys. Number 3. William Shakespeare, of all people, indirectly caused a continental ecological disaster. In the late 1800s in New York, local bird enthusiast Eugene Schieffelin released 60 of his pet European starlings in Central Park. Why would he do such a foolish thing, you might ask? Well, it's because Shakespeare mentioned starlings in Henry IV, and Eugene wanted to bring every bird species that appears in a Shakespeare play to America. The original population of 60 birds has grown to over 150 million. The European starling basically took over the continent, stretching from southern Canada all the way down to Central America. These birds travel in enormous flocks that can cause anything from crop failures to airplane crashes as they'll get stuck in the jet engine. And these little jerks are also responsible for the decline in the numbers of local birds like bluebirds, woodpeckers, and swallows. Thanks a lot, Shakespeare. Number two. In the US, the release of green iguanas has done varied degrees of damage. These large reptiles have destroyed gardens and landscaping. They've grown accustomed to eating a plant that's a primary food source for the endangered Miami blue butterfly. They've also been found to invade the burrows of the Florida burrowing owl. Inexperienced exotic pet owners inevitably find that there's a downside to owning a green iguana. They grow pretty big, and this means that feeding them becomes super expensive, and they're also known to bite other pets like dogs when the iguana's in its mating season, which is a time when it's more aggressive. But please, these are not reasons to shoo it out your back door. Number one. In 1869, amateur entomologist Etienne Léopold Trouvelot brought gypsy moths to the US. It was an experiment to see if they could be interbred with silkworms as a boost to the silk industry. At one point, the moths were accidentally released from his Massachusetts home, and they gradually spread through the northeastern US. The voracious caterpillars threaten hundreds of trees and shrub species, with a particular taste for oak. This enhances fire hazards and threatens the habitats of other animals. From 1980 to 1994, the US spent about $30 million per year towards the eradication of the gypsy moth. Despite extensive efforts, these moths have survived and thrived.